covering the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. This is WPBF 25 News at 5.
We are continuing our live team coverage of the marriage plea deal. Thanks for staying with us. I'm Victor Blackwell.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny, live at the Palm Beach County Courthouse in downtown West Palm Beach. Today, a plea deal in one of the most heinous crimes our community has ever seen. Paul Merhige was sentenced to 7 consecutive life sentences for killing 6-year-old Michaela Sitton, Michaela's grandmother, Ramon Joseph, and his twin sisters, Lisa Knight and Carla Merhige. Jim and Muriel Sitton, Michaela's parents, were against this plea agreement and pleaded with Judge Joe Marx not to accept it. They wanted prosecutors to take the case to trial and seek the death penalty.
The trauma of that night is inexplicable. One of my regrets, if this were not to go to trial, is that the world will never really hear the horror that we endured that night and that we still live with today. The bullets flying, blood spattering everywhere, bodies falling to the ground, and the screams for him to please stop, people running for their lives.
Muriel Sitton, who is expecting a child this spring, described the torture and the heartache that her family has endured over the past 2 years. Muriel also lost her mother that night, as well as her 6-year-old only child, Michaela. She described how life just stopped the moment Merhige, who was uninvited, came to their home Thanksgiving night. Now, despite the Sitton's pleas, Judge Joe Marx accepted the plea deal. And when he announced his decision, he kind of shared some of his own thoughts, specifically to the Sittons, because the judge was himself a victim of a violent crime.
And Mr. Sitton, I know that you know this. I sat in your seat, unfortunately, as well. So I'm one of the rare people who can look you in the eye and say, I do know how you feel. It's not exactly the same. Everybody's experience is different. But I want you to know I respect your opinion. And I hear you loud and clear. But I think that that does count for something.
Now, what he was referring to, in 1994, his then-wife, Karen Marx, was shot and killed at a deposition in Fort Lauderdale. She was an attorney who was standing in for a colleague. She was not supposed to be at this deposition that day. And the man who was being deposed, pulled out a gun and started firing, killing Karen Marx, who at the time was 4 months pregnant.